Okay, welcome. Giving all praises and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahusha, Ba'ashem, Rokar Kodash. My name is Lamadia, and this video will be entitled La Familia, which means the family. Just like the La Cosa Nostra or the Mafia, which the La Cosa Nostra means this thing of ours. Us that's in the faith, we are a family. Pretty much all Israel is considered to be a family, but the Lord is only dealing with the elect as of right now. But we consider to be a family. And just like the La Cosa Nostra, and the Mafia, they deal with nepotism. And the Most High deals with nepotism. Now we go to the word nepotism. This is the English definition from Oxford. The practice among those with power or influence of favoring relatives or friends, especially by giving them jobs. So, in other words, that's a person with high authority or power, and they put other people in power that are family. And that's what the Lord's going to do with Israel, beginning with his elect. And Esau understand the power of nepotism. That's why he's so strong on pushing college, because college destroyed nepotism. Because when a person go to college, that person is working for another family corporation or another family name, whereas a person building up their own family name or the family business or corporation. And Esau doesn't want that. So he don't mind giving to black colleges. And I remember seeing in the, I call it the EBT Awards, you had Diddy. He was talking about him donating to these different college, these black colleges. You know, I don't know if he was just saying that or he was drunk, but you know, it doesn't make a difference, because the colleges doesn't help Israel. And most of all, the Most High didn't put us in this society to prosper. This was set as a punishment. So going back to nepotism, Esau understand the power behind nepotism. That's why he aimed so strong to destroy and to eliminate among Jake. That's why you might see a company like PC Richard and Son, or whatever company you see, you may see whatever the name is, and it is going to read and Son. You know, you might go to an old diner and might says the Johnsons and Sons, because they understand the power of nepotism. But the Most High deals with nepotism. But as of right now, he only dealing with the elect of Israel. But I want to read Psalms 147 and 18. He sent out his word. I'm reading 19. Let's go straight to the point. He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgment unto Israel. He had not dealt so with any nation. So the Most High only been dealing with Israel and Israel alone. Now it says, as far for his judgment, for his judgments, they have not known them. Praise ye the Lord, Yahabashim Yahusha. Because the law was given to Israel, and the judgment for breaking the law was given to Israel. But what happened is, since Esau put his hands on the law, the Most High is going to hold him accountable. for touching the Bible. But the Most High only done with Israel. But in these last days, he only working with the elect. Now let's go to Deuteronomy 7 and 6. But thou art an holy people unto the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahushah. The Lord thy power, Yahweh, had chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth. So the Most High chosen us above all nations. That's why all the prophets was Israelites. All the priests was Israelites. The Most High only dealt with the Israelites. It was that way in the book of Genesis, and it remained that way all the way to this day. The Most High is only dealing with Israel. But in these last days, the Most High is only dealing with the elect. All right? And everybody that is called is not of the elect. That's why we label ourselves, or we undergo the handle as the hopeful elect. Because that's what keeps us humble. Not knowing that we are of the elect. So we fight to be delivered. Or be part of that number. And being that we're coming back to our identity and to our nationality, we have to come back to having brotherly love amongst each other, having care for one another. No, not like these niggas that's in darkness, because they not carrying themselves as the people of the Most High. They actually model themselves as damn dead heathens, or like wild ass animals that haven't been tamed. Like, we look at Jake, there's no structure among Jake. Now, when you come into this faith, it's not about regurgitation. It's about application. I'm gonna say that again. It's not about regurgitation, it's about application. Cause it's not enough to recite the scriptures. You have to apply them. You know? Any scripture you say about another person, you gotta make sure that you in the clear. Cause then you'll be found as a hypocrite. Cause anything you say is now applied to you sevenfold. So it's about application. Now, this is the book of James 1 and 22. But be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. Because this is just not about just regurgitating what you was taught. Now you have to apply what you was taught. That's what that's why so many guys, they came into Israel, they was teaching, they was cursing out the two-thirds. You know, they'll go on rant when they teaching how the Most High is going to kill the two-thirds, and then two-thirds going to be missile food, they're going to die in a famine. Now, all the things that they said to the two-thirds now apply to them. Because they left the truth, and they went back into the world because they didn't apply the scriptures and the things that was written. Now, verse 23, it says, for if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth the manner of man he was. So that's a God that's a hypocrite. That's a God that, you know, he's a super duper Israelite. You know, when he goes out to the camp, he's speaking powerfully. He's a good speaker. But then after, you know, camp is over, when that garment come off, everything about being an Israelite comes off with it. Cause it was all an act. And that person truly didn't believe. He was just playing into that image. That's all it was. He was just playing into that image. That wasn't really him. That's what them guys get disenchanted. Because the scriptures speaks about, now, let's say you catching hell, you feeling weak. Well, guess what? That means you have to pray to the Most High. You have to fast. These are the essential things to be delivered. Don't get me wrong. We all got our moments. We all got these moments. You feeling down. You feeling alone. You're not feeling like yourself. But then that's the time you got to fast. Because when you fast, what you're doing is an exorcism. And you backing off them demons that's messing with you. Now, so let's move to Matthew chapter 12 and 46. Now it says, while he yet talked to the people, behold, his mother and his brethren stood without, desiring to speak with him. Now to him is referencing toward Yahweh Shah. And they were standing to the side, desiring to speak with Yahweh Shah. Now it says, then one said unto him, Yahweh Shah, behold, thy mother and thy brethren stand without, desiring to speak with thee. But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother and who are my brethren? And he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples and said, behold, my mother and my brethren. So Yahweh Shah said, don't worry about them. You know, they're not part of this circle. The one that believe in the Most High, the one that's of the elect, this small sanctuary, y'all are my family. Y'all are my real family. That's why he said, behold, my mother and my brethren. And it says, for whosoever shall do the will of my Father, which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother. So who said this? Yahweh Shah. So he was saying, you all are the La Familia, and serving the Lord is this thing of ours, La Costa Nostra. We're the real La Costa Nostra. And we're the real, the enlightened one, or the Illuminati's. We're the Illuminati on the right-hand side, the enlightened ones, because we have this word, which is light. First John 4 and 20. If any man say, I love the Most High, and hate his brother, he is a liar. But he that loveth not his brother whom he has seen, how can he love the Most High whom he had not seen? And this commandment have we from him, that he who loveth the Most High love his brother also. So, you know, you see your brother every day, or more often. You know, you can actually see your brother, whereas we never seen the Most High. And the Most High said, like, well, you could see your brother. You never seen him. So if you can't see the brother that who you see, how can you say you love something that you have never seen? So it's all about brotherly love or charity or hospitality. First Corinthians 12 and 22. Nay, much more those members of the body which seem to be more feeble are necessary. Because a lot of times, you know, members of the body, that get overlooked are very essential, like your thumb. You think you don't need your thumb, but without the thumb, you try to grip a cup. It's almost impossible. And when we read, the elect, we represent the body of Yahushua. Yahushua being the head, and we represent the other members of the body. Now it says, verse 23, and those members of the body which we think to be less honorable, upon these we bestow more abundant honor. And only slacker in our uncomely parts have more abundant comeliness. So every member of the body or every person in the faith serve a purpose. Because the Lord had divided each person a different gift. And every gift is useful. Now, verse 24. For our comely parts have no need, but the Most High have tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to that part which lacked. Like, if you don't have eyelashes, like, I was watching, it was something on YouTube about this, disease that they say, Jada Pinkett, I forget the name of it, hold up. Let me just do a quick alopecia, slakia. Now, I remember something popped up on my YouTube feed, and I clicked on that YouTube feed, and it was people that are suffering alopecia. You know, now there's different stages of alopecia. Now, there's some people without eyebrows at all, people without eyelashes, and people that have alopecia, they was talking about how difficult it is having alopecia. They can't grow no hair on their eyebrows. So they will talk about, imagine just being in a 90 degree weather and you sweating, and what you used to having eyebrows, your brows will slow down the sweat or capture that fluid and stop it from going into your eyes. But if you don't have no eyebrows, what happened? your eyes begin to sting. Same thing with your eyelashes. I remember one of the patients suffering from alopecia, they spoke on, or they made an analogy about, you know, imagine just having a windy day, and you know the windy days, and just dust flying everywhere and something blowing your eye. But imagine it being like that all the time because you don't have eyelashes. Because a person with alopecia don't have the ability to grow lashes. So if it affects them. So going back to this scripture, verse 26. And whether one member slack it, verse 25. No, it was 24. And those members of the body which we think to be less honorable. That's why I made the analogy on alopecia. Now it says, upon these we bestow more abundant honor, and our uncomely parts have more abundant comeliness. For our comely parts have no need, but the Most High had tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to that part which lack, that there should be no schism in the body. Schism means differences. And it says, but that the members should have the same care one for another. So what it means, same care one for another. Now, if a brother is in lacking, you're supposed to look out for that brother. Make sure he's good. Make sure he all right. You know, if you see that brother go to camp and you got like holes in his sneakers, you might want to ask that brother what's his circumstance looking like, because maybe he can't afford new sneakers. And if that's the case, you know, brothers could get together, get a collection for him, and get him some sneakers. Simple. Or if the brother need a jacket or a coat for the wintertime, brothers get together, get a collection, make sure that brother have a coat. So these are all things that's comprised of having the same care one for another. Verse 26. And whether one member suffer, all the members suffer with it. Or one member be honored, all the members rejoice with it. Now ye are the body of Yahweh Shah, and members in particular. So there you go. We represent the body of Yahweh Shah. And we have to look out for each other. We are the La Familia. And you got to make sure everybody's doing good. If a brother feeling down, you know, try to, you know, motivate him. Don't kick him while he's down. You know, edify him. The word edify means to build up. So, you know, you want to feed him some scriptures. Because you feeling down, that's a demon. And you have to cast that demon off. Now, ye are the body of Yahweh Shah, and members in particular. Now, let's go to Galatians 6, and I'm going to close with that. Beginning at verse 1. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in fault, fault is talking about blame, right? The brother go off. Ye which are spiritual, restore such at one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself. So you restore him, you build him back up in meekness. You know, because you know you know there've been guys that came around and they just love getting on guys. You know, they just love breaking balls. And I'm gonna be honest, you had them guys that came around and they just got off like breaking balls. That was like a hot, like that was like a high they got off of doing that type of shit. But look around now, them guys ain't around no more. Why? Because they didn't do it in a spirit of meekness, considering thyself. They didn't consider themselves, because you know what? You didn't have mercy on that brother. Guess what? The Lord is not gonna have mercy on you. Lest thou also be tempted. Verse 2. Bear ye one another burdens, and so fulfill the law of Yahweh Shah. So we have to, you know, be able to bear another brother's burden. And brothers, don't be secretive. You got something going on, communicate that. You know, because don't just have in your mind, I'm just going to figure it out by myself. Now, if you need help, ask for help. And then you brothers that see it, if you know that brother's in need, don't just stand afar off and say to yourself, well, he never asked. If you see it, you got to step up. That's being a brother. And that's what family is about. Because that's what Yahweh Shah did for us. Yahweh Shah laid down his life for us. So we got to be willing to lay down life for the brother. So with that, I'm going to close. And Lord willing, this video is edifying. Until next time, I want to say all praise and glory to Yahweh. Ba'ashem Yahweh Shah. Ba'ashem Akakwadash Shalom.